From the sky to the sea, to the air that we breathe, from the depths of the earth to the stars.
The National Premier League Finals brings the winners of all 18 National Premier Leagues across the nation together to compete against the best of the best. Teams play several group games before advancing to knockout rounds to determine the NPL national champion of each age group. This year, three Northwest United teams qualified to compete at this distinguished tournament. For two, it was their national debut.
I think it's a high-level competition. I think there's different styles of play. There's teams that obviously go for a little bit of more direct play, and it's very physical and they're very hard to play against. And then there's other very technical teams which are very good with the ball, move the ball very quick, and it helps our girls understand that you have to be very tactically good and very organized to deal with those sorts of caliber teams.
To get better, you have to get out of your comfort zone. And if you're always in an environment where you're successful, you don't know how to be challenged to push yourself. And sometimes it takes adversity to get to the next level. So anytime you can put yourself in an environment where it's going to challenge you, or put you in an environment where you're not as good as the other player, then you can arise to the occasion.
You grab some people's attention that maybe we're not the center of the universe sometimes, and that we need to work that a little bit harder, and maybe practice our technique and practice our tactics a little bit more, because there are good soccer clubs out there from all across the nation. But for us to be competing with them on such a high level is, really shows our club in a very good light.
I think you're probably going to find that the best players around are going to be at this tournament, so I can only see it as beneficial to our players to see where they need to be at, or if they're at the right level they need to be at to further their careers in soccer, whether it be college or even higher level.
This year, Bryan Soccer Complex in Greensboro, North Carolina was chosen to host one of the most prestigious championships in the country. During one of the hottest months of the year, players faced extreme temperatures and humid conditions.
I think it's affecting the play for sure. I think just the ability to breathe as well as you can do and get through the game in cooler conditions, which is less humid. It's going to take a couple of days for our teams to get used to it, because we're not used to it. But definitely, it's going to slow the game down. You have to be a bit smarter with your play. You can't take away that it's 90 degrees, it's humid, and it's going to affect the breathing and how much energy you can put into the game. So the way you handle it is you have to be a bit smarter with how much runs you make and what you do off the ball and how you organize yourself.
As far as the field, it was fantastic. The fields were in good shape. They were a good size, good width. And I felt like the ball rolled nicely on them. On the first day when it was 90 degrees and raining, it was a little difficult. I started sweating on the sideline and I was stood there doing nothing. So goodness knows how the girls were thinking. So I'm sure that made it very difficult.
Obviously, the players who grew up in the Midwest and maybe the South are used to the humidity. Players from Washington, I think, struggled the first day to deal with the humidity. You can stand and not move and be sweating, and you're going to lose water. So it's very important that players stay hydrated. So I think they were better acclimated to it. But, like all things, once you get a little taste of it, then, you've got to get acclimated, and now it shouldn't become a factor anymore.
I think what we learned from last year when we were prepping for this competition is they don't get as much time on the ball, have to be sharper with their feet, know what they're going to do a little bit quicker. The pressure from opponents is a lot more quicker at this level, the athletic ability of the opponents and just the overall, again, the organisation of teams. So the preparation is, we have to get them fine-tuned to moving the ball a lot quicker, and they have to know what they're going to do a lot quicker than usual, and overall just fitness levels and the physique of the girls. We worked on trying to get them a little stronger and to cope with that added intensity.
Well, I guess the advice I'd give them is, why not keep trying? There's players out there that one of our local players here just signed a contract with the Seattle Sounders that attended Skagovelli College here. So, I don't know why it can't be you,
My biggest advice would be, get out of your comfort zone and never be content with your play. Don't ever be content. When you reach a level where you think you've gotten really good, then seek out another level. okay? And then by doing that, you're always putting yourself in a situation where you're getting out of your comfort zone. And the way we get better as players is getting out of our comfort zone so that we make mistakes. Because the more mistakes we make, the better we become.